I'm acting fake busy. Probably cause you did something to me. Probably cause you wasn't ever with me. Probably know this, but I probably kept it pushing. Cause you probably wasn't ever nothing to me. Wouldn't hit me cause you see me on the TV. Now you wanna love me cause it's easy. Never ever let you do me crazy. Now you wanna love me cause it's easy.
What's happening, my beautiful people? My name is Mike LaBelle, and today we have the time finishing tutorial. I'm gonna call this version 2. I feel like I've mastered this technique at this point. I'm gonna share all that information with you. And anytime you see a tutorial from yours truly, beat up that like button. Bust that thing wide open. My tutorials aren't carbon copies. Anything that I put out in terms of tips and information, it's coming off the dome. I give you everything that I know that's been working for me. I've got your back. Today in particular, we're looking at the 5 steps to help you perfect your timed finishing. Please, by all means, use the comments. I'll get back to you. I'll make sure that we're on the same page. I got you. A lot of you have been asking about my shoes and some of the clothes that I wear. All of that's on Instagram, at Mike LaBelle.
I got it.
You see it on screen, the 5 steps to time finishing, and we're gonna go into more depth with more clip analysis from in-game examples from the weekend league, but I wanna discuss what each of these steps really means. Body positioning, that deals with opening up your body properly and aiming when you use the time finish. One of the biggest misconceptions is that people think if you hit green on time finishing, it's going to be a goal. You still need to open up your body, aim the shot, and also choose the correct shot in that situation. It's not as cut and dry as green finish equals goal, no look finesse shot, no look power shot, you name it. That's just not how the time finishing works. That leads me to point number 2. We're looking at shot selection. Are you choosing the correct shot in that scenario? For example, finesse shot versus a power shot, when to try to hit a volley, just all of the above. And that's normal in any FIFA installment. Number 3, power applied. And this is where you're filling up the bar just like any standard shot. It has nothing to do with your secondary input, which is going to be point number 4, where you're timing that secondary input, which just tells EA and it tells FIFA, this is the moment. I want the time finish. All it is an activation. And number 5, don't be early. It's better to be right on time or even fashionably late when you're executing a time finish. If you're too early, that's when you see the dumb lob or the lack of power or just goes out wide. It doesn't look good. We all know this animation.
I got it.
In our first example, we have a very classic way of scoring goals in FIFA 19. We pass it to Paul Pogba. He's in the right place at the right time. See, my body's already been opened up, so I don't have to do a lot for aiming. It's already been done with my body positioning. That's crucial. That's key. Now, shot selection. In this situation, I would always recommend the finesse shot because even if you don't hit it perfectly, you should score. And from just outside the box, as long as you have the angle, finesse shots are overpowered. They're dangerous. They're deadly. They're clinical. And in terms of powering up the bar, using that meter, if you're going to go with a finesse shot, I would say 2 to 3 bars is going to be in your bread and butter zone. Remember, you have to power up the shot, and then you're using that second input, that timed finish, solely deals with the timing. You're just telling EA that I want to use the time finish. It has nothing to do with the power. You've already powered up your shot. That's been done. So you're basically doing a normal shot, and then you're waiting, and then you're going to hit the shot command once again as a form inputting and telling EA, we want the time finish in this circumstance, and that's gonna be mashed potatoes and gravy. Thanksgiving is coming up. Give me the turkey, give me the ham. Next example, and we've got Luka Modric, who, he does this wonderfully. And you see that ball roll, as you see the freeze frame, that's only so I can get an angle. And you can tell, look at how my body is positioned here with Modric. I now have this angle that's gonna allow me to whip. And that's what it's all about, is creating that angle, which does the aiming for you. And then we're gonna power up, finesse shot, 2 to 3 bars. That area is gonna be your bread and butter. This is a little bit farther out, so this is closer to 3 bars from my experience if you wanna have high success rates. I'm also gonna show you a couple different freeze frames that will help you with timing. Because the key to timing is right when your player is about to strike the ball. And that's when you want to hit the shooting command again. And it doesn't matter if it's a power shot, a finesse shot, a chip shot, a volley. This does not change via the shot selection. Now the timing might change a little bit because some shots are slower, some shots are faster. However, this does not change. It's all about when you're about to connect with the ball or you're connecting with the ball. It's time for you to hit the shooting command, hit the shooting input. And I've got many other examples that we're going to look through at full speed, no freeze frames. I just want to show you guys some of the buildup, how I'm opening up some of the space and different locations that I'm scoring, whether it is inside the box, it's outside the box, it's going to be a finesse shot, it's going to be a power shot. And if you get really good at the time finishing, it's definitely an asset in your gameplay. Every single professional player, competitive player, people that are taking part in the weekend league, at some point are going to be using the time finishing. Even if you maybe are fighting the acceptance right now, it's going to be mandatory. It's just too effective. And even more importantly, finishing is so inconsistent at times in this year's installment that this helps eliminate some of that inconsistency if you're good at timing your finish. If you're able to utilize this, whether it is inside the box, outside the box, it's definitely something that I've noticed. And I wouldn't say that I haven't been an early adopter, but I always am a skeptic. Just because EA announces a new feature doesn't mean that I instantly say, that's gonna be effective, that's gonna be amazing, that's something I need to learn. I try it out and then I start to test it versus different types of opponents. And this is a skill that you need to have 100%, no debating. Thanks again for watching. If you enjoyed it, you know what to do. Drop a thumbs up, man. Turn on notifications. Subscribe if you're brand new to the channel, and I have a lot more content come for you ASAP, ASAP. I be smoking weed for prescriptions. You be on vacation, I be living. And I keep a bad bitch choosing. Used to be with him, but now she's switching. Used to have my next tail chipping. Next door neighbor owe me 50. And that nigga just got paid, so I'm knocking on his door. Yeah, I'm coming through collecting. Need it right now, not the next one. No.